Welcome to the Health Plan Management System, also known as HPMS. HPMS is a secure, internet-accessible information system maintained by the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services. Over 60 HPMS software modules support the business operations of the Medicare Advantage, MA, and Prescription Drug, Part D, programs. Through these automated solutions, CMS strives to streamline business transactions for our private partners as we work together to provide Medicare beneficiaries with a diverse set of high-quality healthcare options. Welcome to the EUA Front-End Interface, EFI, instructional video for new users of the Health Plan Management System, or HPMS. This video is designed for individuals that work directly for a plan organization that is contracted with or pursuing a contract with Medicare. Individuals that serve as a consultant on behalf of one or more plan organizations must refer to the video designed for plan consultants. We will demonstrate how to submit a request for a new CMS user ID and how to gain access to HPMS when you do not already have a four-character CMS user ID. The EFI system replaces the need to send in a paper form to gain access to HPMS by allowing users to submit their own requests online. The EFI generally cuts the turnaround time frame from 2 to 3 weeks down to roughly 2 to 4 days. Please note that if you have an existing CMS user ID with a previous employer, you must delete that ID before you can submit a request for a new CMS user ID. You can submit a request to delete an existing ID to the HPMS user access mailbox at hpms_access@cms.hhs.gov. This request must include your name, the existing user ID, and indicate clearly that you left the organization and need your old ID to be deleted. When using the EFI system for the first time, you are required to create an EFI account. To begin, open your web browser and enter the EFI URL. Click on the Register button. Enter the required information in the respective boxes and create your own EFI username and password. Please note that both the EFI username and the password are case sensitive. The password must be 8 to 24 characters and include one uppercase letter, at least one special character, and at least one number. You must use your individual email address as assigned at your organization. You may not use your personal email or a general email address for the organization in order to create your account. Click on the Sign Up tab and then log out. You will receive an activation email in response to the EFI account request you just entered. Once you receive the activation email from EFI, click on the Activate EFI Account link within the email. Please check your email junk folder if you do not receive the EFI account activation email within 20 minutes. Once you have activated your account, log into EFI using the EFI username and password you just created. From the main screen of the EFI, click on Access and then select New User Request, which will take you to the entry screen where you will enter your information. Select Business Partner from the Category field. Select HPMS from the Type field. Note, failure to select HPMS will result in your request being routed through the wrong workflow, which will delay the creation of your CMS user ID. In the Request Justification field, indicate why you need access to HPMS. You must provide enough detail so that we can clearly understand the activities you are requesting to perform in HPMS. Under the Personal Details link, enter the required information, which is marked with asterisks. Note, when entering your Social Security number, you must include the dashes. Select Contact Details and enter the required information, which is marked with asterisks. Select the additional details and enter the required information. The CMS region facility should already be filled in for you. As an individual that works directly for a plan organization that is contracted with or pursuing a contract with Medicare, select Direct Plan Employee for the I Am A question. Select your organization name by typing your company name and pausing after the fourth letter. A drop-down will appear for you to select your organization name. If your company name does not display in the drop-down list, contact the HPMS Help Desk at hpms@cms.hhs.gov with the subject line EFI to request that the company name be added and provide the associated contract number. Once the company name has been added to EFI, you will be able to continue the process by the following day. Enter the contract number or numbers for which you need HPMS access in the Plan Numbers field. Generally, the contract number or numbers begin with a letter and is followed by four numbers. If you are requesting access for a new pending contract, this number would have been provided to you as part of the Notice of Intent to Apply, or NOIA, process. Select Submit Request. Once you submit your EFI request, you will begin to receive a series of emails both from the ESS or EUA mailbox and HPMS. The first email will explain that your request has been sent to your CMS Point of Contact, or POC, to verify. The POC will either approve the request to move on to the first approver or return the request for modification if the submission did not follow the above instructions. EFI will generate an email informing you of the progress. Once the POC completes the approval, your request will go to your federal approver. Following the federal approval, you will then receive an email providing your new CMS user ID. At this time, a CMS Access Administrator, or CAA, must activate your user ID prior to use. CMS performs activations at least twice each day. There is no need to contact the HPMS Help Desk or HPMS team member for assistance. Following the activation of your user ID, you are required to complete your computer-based training, CBT, within 5 days. Failure to complete the CBT will result in your user ID being revoked. At activation, you will also be connected to the HPMS job code. Please note that your HPMS access will not be available for use until you receive the setup email from HPMS with attached login instructions. Please contact the HPMS Access mailbox if you have not received the HPMS setup email for more than 4 days following issuance of your user ID. The most common issues experienced by users in EFI are: 1. The Social Security number already exists. This issue means that A. You have already submitted a request, or B. You have an existing CMS user ID. You can submit a request to delete an existing user ID to the HPMS User Access Mailbox at hpms_access@cms.hhs.gov. This request must include your name, the existing user ID, and indicate clearly that you left the organization and need your old ID to be deleted. You will then need to save the data you have entered into EFI so that you can continue the submission of your EFI request following the deletion of your old ID. 2. You have trouble logging in, or you forgot the EFI username or password. To retrieve your EFI username or password, go to the main EFI page and use the Forgot Username or Forgot Password instructions. 3. Your company name is not in the system. If your company name is not available for selection, contact the HPMS Help Desk at hpms@cms.hhs.gov with the subject line EFI and request the company name to be added and provide the associated contract number. Once the company name has been added to EFI, you will be able to continue the process by the following day. 4. You don't remember your contract number, or you have not received a contract number. You cannot submit an EFI request without a contract number issued by HPMS. Please ask someone within your organization for a contract number. Generally, this number begins with a letter and is followed by 4 numbers. We sincerely hope that you enjoy your experience interacting with HPMS and find it to be a user-friendly and valuable resource. For more information on HPMS and detailed instructions for EFI, please visit our public website page at the following URL. You can also contact the HPMS Help Desk at either hpms@cms.hhs.gov or 1-800-220-2028. Thank you for taking the time to learn about the Health Plan Management System. Please check back here for additional videos on HPMS functionality. Brought to you by the CMS Center for Medicare, Medicare Drug Benefit and C&D Data Group, Division of Plan Data.